What's up, guys? It's your girl, Frisk Me Good, your favorite fashion designer and fashion icon. And welcome back to my channel, where we talk all things fashion. So today, we're going to be continuing my new series, So Nostalgic, where we talk about iconic fashion brands and fads that made a significant impact on pop culture. In this series, we explore the rise, the fall, or the comeback of fashion empires that made their mark on history. But guys, speaking of history, it's the last week of Black History Month, and y'all know I couldn't continue my series without acknowledging some of the influential Black fashion icons and trends that have significantly influenced today's fashion scene. Now, I don't know about y'all, but the beauty supply store is definitely my happy place. From the lip gloss to the wigs and even the jewelry. Every time I take a trip there, I just feel a sense of connection to the culture. But there's one iconic fashion accessory found in beauty supply stores that became a timeless streetwear staple for Black and brown women around the country. I'm talking about bamboo earrings. If you're from or live in an urban community, you've probably owned a pair at some point. But many people don't know the deep, illustrious history of this ghetto fabulous fashion statement. In this episode, we're going to be exploring the vibrant origins of bamboo earrings and how they captivated a generation of fashion forward women of color in the 1980s and early 90s, and how their influence shaped the modern fashion landscape. With all that being said, let's dive in. While there are several accessories that are associated with hip-hop culture, bamboo earrings are arguably one of the most recognizable of all fashion staples for women. They will rise to popularity in urban communities in the 1980s, and their origins date all the way back to the Bronze Age. Archaeological findings will reveal that women from the Middle Eastern Sumerian civilization were the original pioneers of hoop earrings, considering them not only as adornments, but also as symbols of cultural identity and protection. By approximately 2500 BC, the fashion trend began to spread to regions in Africa, with the Nubian civilization located in present-day Sudan further validating the trend. Soon after, the ancient Egyptians enthusiastically adopted the ancient accessory, embellishing them with their unique religious symbols and precious gemstones. Both men and women, as well as royalty, embraced this fashion statement so much so that their cats were even believed to have pierced ears for the gold hoop earrings.
This object would have been a beautiful cast decoration going on top of a mummy of a cat. It's adorned with a pair of golden earrings. And you do find representations of Bastet when she has a female body and she's wearing those earrings. It's probably an attempt to embellish the piece of art itself and to make them look more human-like.
According to Yekaterina Barbash, an author and associate curator of Egyptian art at the Brooklyn Museum, earrings were seen as something that enhanced one's beauty and sexuality. During the transatlantic slave trade, African women that possessed elaborate hoop earrings and other jewelry were perceived as particularly valuable by slave purchasers. This was not only due to their physical attributes, but also because their jewelry represented additional assets that could be traded for profit. On occasion, these women were allowed to keep their jewelry, wearing it discreetly only in the presence of other slaves, as their owners were oblivious to the cultural significance it held in African traditions. However, the perception of beauty will undergo a significant transformation, leading to a sharp decline in the use of earrings. This shift allowed for the emergence of intricate hairstyles and other forms of alternative jewelry that eliminated the need for ear ornaments as an accessory. At the onset of the early 20th century, gold hoop earrings would slowly make their comeback, with the style being widely popularized amongst women of color and various ethnicities. Championed by the women's rights and Black Power movements, figures such as Josephine Baker, Nina Simone, and Angela Davis started wearing them, reinstating the earrings' cultural currency. The emergence of the Afrocentric style by Black women would emerge as symbols of resistance, strength, beauty, and identity.
This brother here, myself, all of us were born with our hair like this, and we just wear it like this. The reason for it, you might say, is like a new awareness among Black people that their own natural appearance, physical appearance, is beautiful. Black people are aware now. They're proud of it. It's pleasing to them. Dig it? Isn't it beautiful? All right.
By the 1980s, the first rendition of the attention-grabbing door knocker bamboo earrings emerged. Their name derived from their resemblance to actual bamboo, and they were characterized by their hollow structure and noticeable joints, which set them apart from other oversized hoops. The accessory will also feature a variety of popular styles, including dolphin, triangle, trapezoid, heart, and more. The first batches of bamboo earrings were most likely inexpensively manufactured in Asia and circulated through the Asian flea market networks. Their flashy appeal would catch the attention of girls from urban neighborhoods who were attracted to their gaudy style and affordability. Soon after, the trend would become a fashion staple for drag queens, trans women, and non-binary femme dancers in New York's underground ballroom scene. Their creative flair would emit drama, performance, and gritty queer glamour, with the subculture subtly influencing underground hip-hop fashion. During this era, the trend will also emerge amongst Latin American women in Southern California, known as cholas. Particularly, these women were known to deal with gang lifestyle, poverty, and violence. For them, the thick hoop earrings would forever represent their tough exterior and lifestyle, respectively. But it wasn't until black female artists like Salt-N-Pepa, MC Light, and Roxanne Shanté began sporting them in music videos, photo shoots, and TV appearances that bamboo earrings exploded into mainstream popularity, becoming a style symbol in pop culture. In 1990, LL Cool J would also play a significant role in further popularizing the trend by incorporating it into his music. In his song Around the Way Girl, he expressed admiration for the ghetto fabulous aesthetic, expressing his desire for a woman adorned with fake hair and two pairs of bamboo earrings. In the music video, he captured the essence of urban fashion in New York City, documenting black and brown women sporting iconic Around the Way looks on his camcorder. These looks included chunky rope chains, elaborate Kelly-Kalan ponytails, layered hairstyles, crop tops, and airbrushed overalls with one strap hanging down, among an array of oversized earrings. His lyrics will help validate and celebrate the fashion choices of black women, affirming their visibility and cultural significance. Similarly, Destiny's Child's Bootylicious video showcases the trio confidently sporting their blinged out bamboo earrings. And throughout the years, Beyoncé has frequently been spotted wearing various styles of the golden accessory. In addition, actresses such as Megan Good were often seen wearing bamboo earrings on the red carpet. And when characters like Ronnie from the Players Club and Nuno from the movie ATL rocked their bamboo earrings, their appearances on the big screen would further validate the trend's desirability among the it girls of the early Y2K renaissance.
What kind of name is Nunu anyway?
I'm Nunu, cause I always rock the new shit.
By 2001, the trend would face a cultural appropriation controversy when Sex and the City costume designer Patricia Field dressed the fictional character Carrie Bradshaw in a 14-karat gold Carrie nameplate necklace and a custom-made pair of Carrie bamboo earrings. The style would become a part of Carrie's fashion-forward uptown girl look in the earlier seasons of the show. But in a later season, when Carrie snooped around her boyfriend's belongings and discovered he bought her a gold engagement ring, she balked at the sight of it. Her trusty and honest best friend Miranda reminded Carrie during a brunch with their girlfriends that she typically wore gold jewelry. To this, Carrie responded sharply, distinguishing the differences between her usual preference for casual ghetto gold and the significance of the engagement ring.
I threw up. I saw the ring and I threw up. That's not normal.
That's my reaction to marriage.
What did the ring look like?
Well, that's the other thing. The ring was not good.
What do you mean?
It was a pear-shaped diamond with a gold band.
Oh, ick!
Ugh, no wonder you threw up.
It's just not me.
You wear gold jewelry?
Yeah, like ghetto gold for fun, but this is my engagement ring.
As depicted in Sex and the City, the issues that arose remained a distant concern by those outside of marginalized communities. The personification of the scripted appropriation parallels reality. with society's implicit role in perpetuating the normalization of disenfranchisement. Patricia Field would even take credit for propelling the trend into the limelight, later admitting to observing young street dwellers sporting what was dubbed the ghetto gold aesthetic outside of her storefront in the 1990s. While Field's style choices catapulted Sarah Jessica Parker to fashion icon status, it consequently invalidated the appropriateness of those same styles on women of color. But just like that, nameplates and bamboo earrings surged into the world of haute couture, marking a shift where the classic Black and Latino New York street style became coveted by affluent white women around the country. As a result, high-end fashion houses like Balenciaga and Celine began offering them in prestigious department stores such as Neiman Marcus and Saks Fifth Avenue, with other luxury retailers following suit. The trend went from tasteless, cheap, and even sleazy by outsiders to a sought-after vintage look to emulate. Since coming to the forefront, bamboo earrings have continued to resurface, with women of color steadily sporting the look. However, nearly every revival of the trend has been met with accusations of cultural appropriation. For example, Taylor Swift caused controversy when she appeared in her Shake It Off music video in 2014, sporting the gold bamboo earrings with denim cutoffs, knee pads, and a cropped leather bomber jacket. These elements, along with her attempts to twerk and breakdance in the music video, prompted criticism from many on Twitter, accusing her of perpetuating Black stereotypes. But Swift wouldn't be the only one who caught flack for wearing a pair of door knockers, as the Kardashian-Jenner clan, Krishan, and others have also received criticism for doing the same.
I don't like Krishan.
Okay, why don't you like Krishan?
To me, she's like a wigger. And it's nothing personal. Like, I'm, to be honest, like, I fuck with white people the long way. I just did two shows out here. One was at Webster Hall and one was at Westway. Nothing but white people. They went crazy over me. I love, one of my best friends, a white boy, white. So I don't like, to me, Krayshawn remind me of the movie Baps. Okay. The big bamboo earrings, the whole, like, fro, the blonde in the front with the ring curls, like, bitch, is that how Black women look to you, or is that just your style? And I'm saying bitch because if you so down, you know that's how we talk anyway. So it's not like, oh, I'm attacking her like bitch this, bitch that. But at the same time, is that you, or are you trying to imitate a Black girl? So until I actually talk to her and get to know her, I don't like her because I don't like her image. And I don't think she deserved that VMA nomination because she just fresh off the porch, and I believe she got that because she's white, because it's plenty of chicks that's spitting harder than her. I am one. And it's just, I don't like her. It's none personal. I just don't dig her shit. I like the Gucci Gucci song, but I mean, even then it was like a old Memphis flow. Like, it just, I don't see, like, I don't know. I just don't like wiggers. So she remind me of some Baps movie type shit.
Gotcha.
Like a character.
Among the realm of designers and retailers, Urban Outfitters faced scrutiny in 2016 when they introduced bamboo earrings priced at $16 each. Renee Jackson, a 24-year-old at the time who was living in Brooklyn, told BuzzFeed News she literally laughed out loud when she spotted them in the store. Baffled, she wrote a post wondering why a prominent fashion fixture in the Black community was being rebranded and revalued. Her post was shared more than 16,000 times, with her caption reading, "The same earrings that people find ratchet or ghetto on Black women are now $16 and sold at Hipsters R Us. These are literally a dollar at the nearest Black hair store. My culture says you're welcome." Conversely, Givenchy's Riccardo Tisci, a designer of Italian descent, garnered acclaim from the fashion world for his 2015 Victorian Chola collection, featuring his take on door knockers.
Riccardo Tisci loves drama, and his latest collection for Givenchy didn't disappoint. His own theme was Victorian Chola, but everybody here saw something different.
Well, I had no idea we were doing finger waves in the hair for the show. I just did this on my own. I was like, when they were walking down the runway, I was like, I love this. I loved all the face jewelry, and I thought that that was really appealing to me. I'd wear some of that.
I loved it. I think it was absolutely amazing. I was kind of holding my breath. I loved all the jewelry. It's very powerful, but like some kind of sadness over it that I'm very drawn to. It is a little bit like flamenco. It's like heart and blood and death and life. And I think it was amazing.
But the brand would spark outrage for using the Chola subculture as their inspiration for the show, and largely ignoring the women who have popularized the looks. Jifan Chi shared numerous images from the show on Instagram, including close-up shots and behind-the-scenes photos backstage, yet none of them would feature women of color. This was particularly notable considering that approximately 20% of the runway cast comprised of non-white models. Additionally, the hair and makeup team was predominantly white as well, creating a complete lack of diversity in a show claiming to honor a culture that was negligently underrepresented. The term Chola also carries complex connotations because it was initially derived from the ancient Aztec term for dog or mutt, and was historically used in a derogatory manner to describe Mexican immigrants. Over time, it was reclaimed by certain gangs in the 1970s, and although the term has become more widely recognized, its usage should be approached with sensitivity and culture, as its history is filled with derogatory context. As Refinery29 put it, the message this sends is that baby hairs can look chic on white girls, but are still hood on Latina and Black girls. While non-Black celebrities, high-end fashion brands, and even fictional characters have all taken their swing at appropriating the style, it's imperative that we acknowledge the roots of the trend, no matter how many times the bamboo earrings is sent back and forth across the lines of being appropriated to being ridiculed. The trend has evolved to reflect changing trends and styles, but their true essence remains the same. They represent a celebration of boldness, individuality, and flamboyant self-expression among communities of color. From the urban streets to the realms of pop culture, this iconic accessory remains a source of inspiration and empowerment for women worldwide. Now regarded as a ubiquitous fixture in the jewelry collections of the fashion forward, bamboo earrings persist as a vital link to our heritage, fostering a profound connection to the culture. From their ancient origins to their modern day resurgence, bamboo earrings continue to bridge the gap between heritage and contemporary style. Their journey through history reflects the resilience and creativity of the communities that have embraced them, making them an iconic fashion accessory with a rich story past. But there you have it, folks, the illustrious history of bamboo earrings and their influence on streetwear. Let me know in the comments below if you own a pair or have owned a pair of bamboo earrings in the past, or if you just enjoyed this video, leave me a comment letting me know what fad or fashion empire you want to hear about next. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so we can talk all things fashion. Okay, bye.